they missed it. He actually says, hello, CitizenCon, but you guys are all laughing when you saw the guy. Constellation Aquila. This is contrails. So we're heading towards the distress beacon. So the idea with this would be that, you know, you potentially could get a mission where you get a distress beacon and you're going to find out on, you know, in this particular case, this planet. So we're heading towards it. I think this is telling us the atmospheric conditions are unsafe. And one of the key gameplay things you want to do on, because obviously the planetary tech is going to allow us to have a whole bunch of play areas we don't normally have, is to encourage players not to always, you know, maybe you can't always fly there. Maybe you have to get out and use your rover, for instance, which you have in a color. So it's fine. Let's go find in a landing zone that's on the edge of the desert plain. You know, it's a little compression there. We've been working on that thing for the... I know it's a small thing, but I always want to have the landing gear compressed when you land. All right, so we're going to head out to do some exploring and... the armor on. Get us out. Let's be nice and tidy, close the locker up, and then grab our gun just in case there's some hostiles out there. But this is kind of an example. Like, for instance, you shouldn't be able to sort of sit in heavy armor flying a ship. Maybe you're in your flight suit, and then you go and equip your armor or your EVA suit when you need to go outside and do stuff. And so you sort of want to make it quite immersive and have different reasons to be equipping and using different stuff. So if you notice, this is the actor that we had that was in Pupil to Planet. He's actually in Squadron 42. He plays a character called Joachim Steiger. So let's go and see the distress beacons about almost 3 kilometers away over there. We get our the scope out. All right, so let's figure out how to get there since we can't fly. So, handily, we've got the Constellation Killer, so we have... rover. So, you know, you saw the Constellation Killer commercial a while ago. We are now doing this in-game, in real time. Awesome. And, you know, unlike, I mean, all those mounds we see, if we have the time, we don't hear, but I'm sure when you guys get on Quark Planets V2, there'll be lots of videos where people walk all the way around the planet, or they go to the mountain they see in the distance, because that is not a skybox. That is actually the proper mountain, the geometry that's all there, everywhere. And that's actually the liberating thing with this tech is when we build the planet on a planetary scale in this level of detail, and of course you can see up close that it like, looks like what you see at Battlefield 1, for instance, in the desert, there, sort of Lawrence of Arabia. But of course it's all at a global scale, the whole planetary scale. And we have different ecosystems, obviously we've flown through, so we flew over oceans, we flew over sort of grasslands or forest or over through mountains, and now we're sort of at sort of the edge of a desert and approaching a desert. Looks like someone didn't heed the atmospheric unsafe flight warning. If we take a look back here, you can sort of see where we came from, about 2.5 kilometers back there. So we're heading past this rock out, this set of this sort of canyon walls to head to the distress beacon. check out something else we had here. A little bit of breadcrumbs. Orpheus Horizon Javelin Pass. Where that came from. All right, let's carry on. See if there's anyone around. We'll head that way to get to the distress beacon. Music changing here is all part of the dynamic music logic system. So it'll start to calm down now that the combat's over. Right, so that's, well, we lost our rover, that's not so good. That's where the distress beacon's coming from. Was a trap. Conveniently, some sand nomad dragonflies. Had our shot moment. Here we go. Right, we got one, we got another distress beacon we've linked to, so let's go look for that. And remember, we came all the way down from planet, all the way down here, and we're down driving around at this level of detail. So that's kind of a big testimony to the what the Proc Planet V2 stuff does, and the tools has given the artist a looks amazing. You wouldn't think that it's at a global scale. escape pod. If you like to, and we activated the other escape pod speaker. So Vince, by the way, Vince is our lead QA in Los Angeles. He's a much better pilot than me. So you should give your appreciation. Otherwise, you'd have me crashing into things. See up there, that's the space station. And if you look closer, you can actually see the rings slowly rotate. But that is the space station we flew past on the way down. And that's kind of what the sort of tech and the 64-bit precision for positional space gives you. We just can have this dynamic range of scale that I don't think any other game has. So all this up close detail at this level, at, you know, as high quality first person as you see in any other game, but on a global or a planetary or even star system scale. Right, so Orpheus, Horizon, Black Box. So we've now, between the two pods, triangulated to where the Black Box of the Orpheus Horizon is, which is the crashed spaceship. And hopefully we'll find it. Is undeterred by the impending sandstorm. But seriously, the sandstorm's an example of we want to have dynamic weather on the procedural planets, and we're working to have sort of a dynamic procedural weather system and things like sandstorms, hurricanes, various weather systems are all big to model on the planets that will add additional sort of drama and challenges for when you're adventuring and playing around. All right, let's go check out these wreckages. Maybe dangerous out in the desert, who knows? That looks like the Orpheus Horizon in the desert. But we're just gonna do it! And go out there. Yeah, I know, I gotta memorize that whole speech. showed you a crashed Starfarer, this is a crashed Javelin. Pop off here. Still about 200 meters away. And, check out how we're going. Hang on a second. It's like there's a that nomad. So should we shoot it? Alright. Oh! Nice shot, man. Vince got cocky. He's like on the move, too. Sneak up behind him. Watching the incoming sandstorm. That looks like it's getting close. Okay, let's get out of here. Shit. Hurry up, man. Lost our way in. Yeah, let's see here, that's where the black box is. That's where the black box would be. So let's see if we can find a way out. first time it's ever done that. But you get to see the pullout twice now.
How did it go to the console?